This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're looking for evil guys.
What the voice is
people must be heard.
Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening on the
first I give you a warning. Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
All right. Hey, everybody. Welcome to the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. This is our last podcast before the new year, 2017. So
Happy
get
New Year.
Happy New Year. Get ready to start writing the date wrong for approximately 6 months.
Yeah, and wait in line for the gym. Because every motherfucker's going to be at the gym.
Yeah, fucking New Year, new me. Fuck you.
Yeah, fuck you.
You lying sacks of shit.
Speaking of 2016, they just... It couldn't rest. It had to take one more.
Actually, two more. Oh, but two I know more. The one you're getting at.
Oh, yeah. George Michaels. Oh, had to take him.
George Michael.
Oh, had to take him, man. Oh.
The immortal words of Ryan Reynolds.
Wham. They just picked him up before they go-go. Oh, man.
Yeah, don't make fun.
I know. Oh, and that's another thing, dude. The internet memes are already out for this.
Too soon.
Like, hours after they announced it, there's just fucking all sorts of crap about him. There were some really brutal ones. I was like, God damn.
You know, the dude wrote Careless Whisper at 17. What'd you do at 17?
I know. I think Pick Me Up Before You Go-Go, whatever the name of that song. That's one of the catchiest fucking songs in the world.
Yeah, between them and, you know, him and Andrew Ridgely.
Nah, oh, jeez. Like, that song is so catchy. I don't care if he put dicks in his mouth, whatever. And 53, I was surprised about 53. Did he do drugs?
Oh, yeah, he did lots of drugs. Yeah. He had a long history of substance abuse issues.
Oh, God, yeah. I figured, I saw 53, and I was like, God damn, that's young.
He's supposedly been clean recently, but, you know.
Well, see, that's what I see happen a lot. Like, my grandmother, she quit smoking. She smoked for, like, 40-some years, quit smoking, died 6 months later. I think your body's not used to it. It's just like, I'm giving up.
Yeah, maybe.
They like the abuse, I guess. I don't know. Jesus.
All right. So for today, we have a pretty cool.
I'm a little scared about this one.
We call this one's made by Weyerbacher, and it is called Insanity.
Yeah, I got a picture of it here. Oh, man.
Yeah, they take their Blithering Idiot barley wine, which is also pretty good, and then age it in oak bourbon casks.
Would you say this was 11%?
11.1%.
Well, I'm not doing anything today.
No. So, shall we?
Yeah, let's go ahead.
Let's give it a try here. It's a barley wine. That is surprisingly smooth and...
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of sweet.
Yeah, most 11% or even like above that gives. Oh, there it is. Never mind. A little bit of like a throat punch.
Yeah.
And it, not at first. It's really smooth at first, and then it really kicks in. That's not as bad as I thought it was going to taste like fucking kerosene or something. But that's actually really smooth.
Yeah, it's got a lot of it's got a lot of that vanilla flavor. I mean, I'm getting a little bit of the bourbon taste.
Yeah, it's definitely a barley wine. Like, that is, like, holy fuck, man.
That is really good, though.
I know, but, oh, God.
You're not going to want to drink this one fast.
You know? And I was going to go to the Verizon store today, but I'm not doing that for a while. Oh, man, that punches you right in the dick. I got to try that again.
That's good.
It's really good.
Very good. I'm definitely getting, like, vanilla.
Yeah, definitely vanilla. I think it's worth it, though. When you said you got this beer, I was like, oh, man, this is going to be a oneer. But I'm actually really, really shocked about this.
Yeah, it's pretty tasty.
Yeah. Barley wine isn't my favorite, though.
I think it's the aging process that really mellowed it out.
Yeah, I just... And in honor of George Michaels today, I am going to rate this 3.5 wham exclamation marks out of 5.
Dude, I'm going a straight 4.5. This is really? One of the best barley wines I've ever tried.
And see, that's the thing. It is really, really delicious. I'm just not a big barley wine fan. And it actually, I've had a lot of barley wines because I've worked in microbrews and stuff, and that's probably the smoothest one.
Yeah, that was the aging process definitely has a lot to do with it. It's got to be.
Yeah.
That's really, really good. And this one is made in Easton, Pennsylvania, so I don't know if it's a local thing or whether you can get that one outside of the area. But if you can get a hold of it, especially my other other beer-loving friend, KP, you know, if you can get a hold of this one, give it a shot, but don't plan on doing anything later.
Yeah, I'm fucking wasted already.
Did you bring up the label for all to see?
I did. I'll bring it up one more time. Oh, man.
There you go. It looks like there's a jester waiting in the wings to stab you.
Yeah. He's just going to fucking stab you, cut out your liver, because you're not going to have one anymore after drinking this.
Right.
Oh, man. That's... Ugh. Ugh.
And now I have a special thank you for my daughter who gave us a better Bead and Boozled set.
Yeah.
This one has a metal top with a spinner on it, so now we won't just get like three items.
It's more dramatic. I like that little gring.
Yeah, it sounds good on the mic.
Yeah.
All right, for all you sadistic bastards out there, no, we're not playing Would You Rather Today.
Yeah, we're not playing that again. I had to play that at Christmas. My brother got that for Christmas, and
Bean Boozled.
I played it again for some reason, and I got Dead Fish this time. That was pretty rough. Yeah, guess what my first one was?
Spoiled Milk.
Was that one horrible or what? That was worse. And the bad thing
was
when I woke up the next morning, I had that Dead Fish Spoiled Milk taste in my mouth. And it was god-awful. Ugh.
Yeah, man. This one's neat. It comes in little packets, so we can be sure to keep the horrid fresh.
Oh, shit. No way. Yeah. Oh, there's already some missing.
we played a little.
Oh, man, yeah. I can see the devil in this one laughing at us. Fuck that game. Anything's better than that Goya shit, though. That shit was fucking... Ugh.
I don't know. That one's better than the Spoiled Milk,
I think. Yeah, but I don't care. I'm in a good fucking mood. If people notice, we have a fucking camera this time.
Yes.
That works.
Yes, we're saying this, and there'll be like 10 fucking problems with it by the time this is over with.
We actually used this camera last week, but my computer was such AIDS from, you know, playing World of Warcraft and having all these games downloaded on and from Steam and everything like that, so the frame rate was shit, but we think we got it figured out this time.
Yeah, we had to wipe his computer, and now we got everything all straightened out, I think. The picture looks pretty good to me, so...
Yeah. Because we were talking about it. I'm just like, you know what? I'm spending the money. Christmas is coming up and everything like that. So I was like a little, but I was like, fuck it. Anytime something stresses me out, I just throw money at it.
It's good to have a friend like that.
Yeah. And then once we hooked it up, it didn't work right. I'm like, I fucking hate my life.
Well, we knew if we kept at it, we'd get it figured out. So we finally, after all this time, knock on wood, finally have a camera that's halfway decent. So. Yeah.
Oh, man. Thank God.
So for those of you who have been avoiding our YouTube stream like the plague, you should definitely watch our YouTube show.
Yeah, it looks a lot better now. We still look like shit because we're ugly, but, you know, the video at least
looks good. Yourself, motherfucker. I'm sexy as hell.
Yeah. Well, you know, you're married and everything. I'm still, you know, on the... No, I'm not.
I tried to get my wife to come on the show today.
Oh,
she,
really?
She's off from work today. I tried to get her to come on. She wouldn't do it.
Well,
She's sick, really.
Oh, is she?
She was going to do it if I could find somebody to watch the kids for an hour while we do the show, and then she's sick, and she wouldn't do it. So.
Do you think she would have done it if she wasn't sick?
Maybe, with enough wheedling. I was wheedling her because I think she's hilarious.
My
wife doesn't say anything very often, but when she does, they are just like these cutting zingers. They're hilarious.
Yeah, she is pretty funny. Now that we get that all clear out of the way, do you want to start off, Jay, or do you want me to go first?
Since you said you have a bunch of serious shit, let's start off with something fucking hilarious first.
Yeah, I really don't have... It's serious. It's just for some reason, I have some things that piss me off today.
Well, that's the point of the show.
Go ahead.
All right, so here's a good one. And since, like I said, we're trying to bring you the adventures of Pennsylvania Man to counteract with his counterpart, Florida Man. Pennsylvania Man, 89, heads out to store, ends up in Alabama.
How old was this motherfucker?
89, I just said. Pay attention, motherfucker.
I couldn't help it. This fucking beer is putting me in another dimension, dude. I feel like everything's moving in slow motion.
By the end of the show, we're all going to be destroyed.
Oh, man.
So, yeah, this guy who lives on the outskirts of Philadelphia, he wanted to go to the neighborhood hardware store for some electrical stuff.
Mm-hmm.
He ends up in fucking Alabama.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, he disappeared. He approached officers on Monday in Alabama and asked where he was. He was stunned. Stunned that they found him, or that where he was, and they took him to the police station and discovered he'd been missing for 2 days. And they found a way to get a hold of his family and notify him that he's been found. But how about that? They took him to the hospital where he's treated for blood pressure and dehydration. But the daughter, I think it was, said that there was no signs previously of Alzheimer's or dementia.
Yeah. But now, does he have it? Like, did they diagnose him with anything?
I have no idea at this point, but all I know is if Grandpa goes missing for 2 days, try checking three states away.
Yeah, Grandma got ran over by a reindeer. Not anymore. They just get fucking lost going to the grocery shopping or wherever the fuck he went.
One of the stories I read, they said that they found his car. He had, like, two children's hamburgers from McDonald's and shit in. So he was, like, feeding himself.
I know, but why was he dehydrated, though? He didn't go into the world.
I don't know. That's the world's answer for everything anymore. I'm sorry I acted erratically. I'm dehydrated.
What the fuck, man?
Fucking nonsense.
He didn't go, like, mountain climbing or anything. What the hell? Oh, that's great. That's going to be me when I get older, if I ever reach that age. I'm probably going to die at 53 like George.
Oh, man. I've
been pretty good. I wanted to do a meme section of George today, but I thought it was a little too soon.
Yeah, well, you know what? In the other one they took today, well, this is Tuesday, remember. I saw today was one of the kids who was on Everybody Hates Chris.
Mm-hmm.
He did some work with like Snoop Dogg and shit, I guess. He was one of the neighborhood bullies.
Since he did stuff with Snoop Dogg, did he record a shitty album like Le'Veon Bell?
Le'Veon Bell.
I can never say his fucking name.
No, but I heard a pretty good one. I'm a Steelers fan here, so I'm going to get some hate probably. But I saw a pretty good one that said, every time Bell runs, a raven loses its wings.
Oh, that's hilarious. Actually, I think I did see that. But every time I watch him play now, I just think of that fucking shitty, horrible song he was.
Gotta have focus. Focus!
My favorite part still is where he's like, people think I'm smoking. I'm like, you were, buddy.
Like, I'm pretty sure you got suspended for it.
Yeah, twice. And I was like, oh, come on, Bell. Just take the blame, man. Just take the blame. Speaking of football, though, Cowboys. Woo! Finally, Cowboys. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you Cowboys fan.
Tony fucking homo. Dude, I called it. I said they are not going to do anything unless they get rid of Romo. Look what happened.
Is he still injured or?
No, he's on the side. There was talk of him, you know, coming back. I was like, Jerry Jones, you're a fucking retard.
Oh, I didn't know they released him. I thought he was just on IR.
Oh, no. He's in the back there just sitting there with his little coat on, smiling. He's like, yeah.
Look at me. I'm a pretty boy.
Yeah. Smell my fingers. It has Jessica Simpson, Carrie Underwood on him. I think that's why he doesn't give a shit. He's just like, whatever.
I got bitches.
Yeah, that's what I hated about him. He'd walk off the field after just blowing the game. He'd be smiling. He'd be like,
yeah, look at me.
I could eat Carrie Underwood's butthole when I get home. Why in the fuck do I care? Ugh.
Yeah, good point.
But Dak, baby, Dak! Woo! All right, I had a little bit of a moment there. I'm actually not a big football fan. I used to be a long time ago, but I had to give a shout out.
Well, it's getting to the fucking point where every play anymore, you can't celebrate, you can't get happy because there's going to be a fucking flag.
I know. What's his name? The Cowboys versus, who was that? Tampa Bay. There was a Salvation Army pot at the end of the end zone to promote, you know, Salvation Army. Well, what's his name? Ezekiel scored a touchdown. He ran over to the pot and jumped in it and like peeked down and peeked up. 61% donations went up. They still flagged him for it.
Of course. Oh, you know, and some of the ones I hate are the illegal hands to the face ones. Like, the hand brushes against the helmet and you get the illegal hands to the face. It's one thing if you grab somebody by the face mask and horse collar them down. I get you. You wrench it on someone's head. But it's like you brush your hand against somebody's mask anymore and you get a fucking hands to the face call.
Yeah, and I'm not joking. I actually seen this in a college game. I don't know if this is in football. I didn't even know it was a fucking thing. But roughing the center. You know the guy in the middle that takes all the shit that's supposed to get fucked up? They got called on the defense for roughing the center, and they replayed it, and all he did was run and push him, and the guy fell down.
That's what you do.
That's what you do. And I was like, I rubbed my eyes for a second. I was like, is this real life?
This is why I don't follow college sports right there. Like, that can't be in the NFL.
I didn't know it was in college. Like, look it up. I swear to God, it's a real thing.
I believe it.
It was, oh my God, I just couldn't believe it. I was like, no wonder all the kids are pussies.
Yeah, really. Pull the fucking panties out of your ass. You make millions of dollars to play a children's game. I don't want to hear about your concussions or anything else.
And actually, I'm going to look into that and see if that's in the NFL because that's just, let's see. Roughing the center. Where you get most of the contact, probably. Like, oh, man.
There's a reason why centers are big men.
Yeah, huge motherfuckers that will eat your kids. Like,
I mean, have you seen like Marquise Pouncey, for example? He's a big man.
Oh, man.
There's a reason why he's a big man.
I know. I just, it's getting to the point where it's such pussified.
Yeah.
I just want them to all take a bunch of raging steroids or injecting them all with rabies and just watch them eat each other. Oh, that'd be great.
Yeah, I think it's hilarious. You know, oh, we can't have performance enhancing drugs. No, I want more performance enhancing drugs. Give them all steroids.
Yeah.
Put them all on a level playing field. Then there'll all be a bunch of roided up supermen.
Yeah, like, could you imagine NASCAR with nitrous tanks and all of them?
Oh, yeah. I'm just waiting to the day when the NFL's, like, replaced with, like, cyborgs and shit. Like, you lose it. You're all roided up supermen. They Beat lose an arm. Football. Yeah, they replace them Beat with fucking football. Cybernetics.
Yeah. Oh, man. I love that game. Oh, beautiful game.
The fucking sound effects of the ref. Yeah, 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 yeah.
I completely forgot about that part until you said it. I just remember wiring the football and you throw it into the opposite team and it just blows them all apart. You lose a down, but you don't care. Everyone died.
you bribe the refs and they start calling ridiculous plays.
Yeah, I forgot about penalties. That part too. Oh, that you did say something about Sega has a version of that new Nintendo that they came out with.
They're working on one, I guess.
Oh, okay.
I mean, there's one.
That has Mutant League Football and I'm sold.
Well, there's one you can go to like Toys R Us and buy one, but I don't know if it's like officially licensed or whether it's kind of legal gray area sort of situation.
Yeah. I still can't find them anywhere. Like, I went to the store. I was going to get my brother one because he likes Tecmo Super Bowl and Mike Tyson's Punch Out, and still couldn't find it.
Oh, they're impossible to get right now. Give them a few months. They'll be ready.
I hope because I want one like bad. Like, I actually want to do some stuff on the show, like play Tecmo with each other, and like whoever fucking loses has to stand outside with a sign that says free hugs in a schoolgirl outfit. And doing that out here, you're going to get some looks. Probably shot, but whatever.
Please don't sue us, Nintendo, but chances are the only way that we're going to be able to do that is to play it on the computer there with an emulator so that we can screen cap it.
Oh, yeah, I have no idea. That's all you, buddy.
I'll work it out.
Yeah, that's all you because I don't know any of that. I'm still trying to get used to all this shit.
Yeah, I'll work it out. I'll figure it out.
We just got a webcam working.
Well, that was more of a money situation than anything.
Yeah, it was. The phone was working good for a while. It split the videos up and it made editing like shit. Like, it sucked.
Yeah, it's fucking the European Union's fault for that shit. If it records, according to EU rules, if it records for longer than like 15 minutes or something like that, it has to be classified as a camcorder, which is a different tax rate.
Oh my
God. So they have to split it up like that.
No wonder people go nuts and kill the people in their government. Jesus Christ. That is the dumbest shit I've ever fucking heard in my life. Oh my goodness.
Speaking of that, did you hear about the guy who thought he killed Trump?
Really? Was this a dream that he had or something?
No, he's just mentally ill, and he thought he shot Trump.
Did he freak out?
I don't know. I don't know exactly what happened. I wish I thought I saved the story, but I guess not. But anyway, the dude kind of like went. He was loony, and he thought for sure he had killed Trump. And he said he had
did. He
like
turn himself in, or
yeah, he turned himself in.
Oh, he felt guilty about it. He's like, somehow I got over the wall. Oh, man. He's like, I killed him. I couldn't help it. Does it go into detail about how he killed him or anything? Or?
No. Let me see here. Man accused of murder believed he shot Trump. Here, here we go.
This wasn't me. A picture of me is not going to come up, is it?
He kind of looks a little bit like
him. Yeah, he does. Actually, he looks like Kylo Ren from Star Wars. Doesn't he?
Yeah. All right. So he pled guilty to murder. Yeah, okay. Did he actually kill somebody? Okay, yeah. So he killed a UPS driver in the parking lot of a Walmart and claimed that he believed he shot and killed President-elect Donald Trump.
Wow, they look a lot alike, dude. Oh, my God. So he actually did kill someone and he thought it was Trump.
Yeah, he thought it was Trump.
Do they have a picture of the UPS driver?
No, I have not seen that.
Watch it look just like Trump.
I guess it could, but...
Oh, man, that's hilarious.
Yeah, so he said during his arraignment, I shot and killed Donald Trump purposely, intentionally, and very proudly. Hmm. And he still believes he shot Donald Trump.
If I was the guys around him in jail, I would sit him in front of the inauguration like, and just be like fucking with him like the whole time. Like give him pills, like sugar pills, and say that it was like, you know, something to get inside your head and like just fuck with them. That'd be a fun time. Where's this guy from? Not Pennsylvania or Florida.
Ithaca. Ithaca, New York.
New York. Well, Pennsylvania, not something from Pennsylvania or Florida. I can't believe it.
Yeah, he pled guilty, and the judge refused to accept his guilty plea because he's obviously nuts.
I was thinking, man, I hope I didn't like sleepwalk and do this. I was waiting for a picture of me to come up. I wonder what you get. Do you think you get the death penalty for shooting the president?
Probably. I mean, what happened to Lee Harvey Oswald?
I don't know. I just know the names. I don't know.
Well, yeah, never mind. Lee Harvey Oswald was assassinated, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah, that's right. He was shot right after it, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was.
Yeah.
Somebody else killed him.
And he was the one that shot JFK.
Right, yeah.
What happened to the guy that shot Reagan? What was his name? Wasn't he some guy obsessed with some star in Taxi Driver or something?
I don't know. Let me see here. Reagan assassination.
FBI is going to be like, what?
Hinckley. That's his name. Yeah, Hinckley.
John Hinckley. Yeah.
Let's see what happened to John Hinckley.
He was probably assassinated. If he was assassinated, like, all the conspiracy theorists nuts are going to go crazy.
let's see here. Reagan assassination attempt. 13 offenses found not guilty by reason of insanity. All right, so. Well,
is he still alive?
I don't know. Let me see here. Yeah, he's 61.
Oh, shit. So he's just like out in the streets
for a living. Well, no, he's in a mental hospital.
I was gonna say, man. Jesus.
No, never mind. Apparently, gee, I'm glad you brought this up. Apparently, in July this year, a federal judge ruled that Hinckley would be allowed to be released from St. Elizabeth's, treatment center. On August 5th, as he was no longer considered a threat to himself or others. The conditions of his release are that he has no contact with the Reagan family, the Brady family, or Jody Foster.
That's who it was. He was he shot him to impress Jody Foster.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. He will live with his 90-year-old mother and be restricted to a 50-mile zone around her home in Williamsburg, Virginia. Hinckley was released from institutional psychiatric care on September 10, 2016, will live full-time at his mother's home. As part of his release, he's excluded from speaking to the press, has to work 3 days a week, can drive no more than 30 miles from his mother's home or 50 miles if attended, and must see a psychiatrist twice a month.
Dude, what? He got released just in time to try to assassinate Donald Trump. Watch him try to do it.
Dude, if somebody shoots that fucking idiot, then they're coming back to us now. You know that, right?
I know, dude. But just watch it happen. And once he does, he's going to go in front of the camera. He's like, told you not to let me out. He does jazz hands.
if John Hinckley comes out and shoots Donald Trump, they are coming back to us, and we're going to be in prison. Thanks,
yeah.
Dick.
That's all right. I'm already in prison. In my mind.
Do you think they'll let us do our show from the
Stony Lonesome? That would be awesome. I'd go to prison if they still let us do this show.
Coming to you live from the Stony Lonesome.
Every hour, 24 hours a day, because we have nothing better to do.
Because it's better than getting gang raped in the showers. Yeah.
Oh, man. That's the thing. Like, I couldn't survive prison because of the boredom. I have friends that were in there, and they're
I'm
like...
I'm too pretty.
Yeah, like, I couldn't fucking do it. I just heard it is so freaking boring. Like, you just lose your mind. And the one guy that we have there, his name's Brooks, and he's such a germ freak. And he was, like, freaking out because he was, like, flushing all the toilets with his foot and stuff.
He is a germaphobe.
Yeah.
Brooks watches this show. So, hi, Brooks.
Oh, does he?
Yeah, he does. He told me
shit.
He likes it.
Oh, no shit. Oh, that's right. Yeah, he told Ron that. I didn't talk to him. He came in to the bar one night, and I wasn't there. So, I remember he was talking to Ron about it. Hi, Brooks. Speaking of jail, I do have a story.
Uh-oh.
I don't know why this sparked my hatred for some reason. I'm just really upset about this. This would suck so much.
You angry little man.
Yeah, just Tennessee man gets $75 check to restart his life after being wrongfully imprisoned for 31 years.
Wait. How much?
$75.
All right, so $75. Let's do the math here. $75.
I think they forgot to count for inflation.
Divided by how many years? 30?
31 years.
Oh, 31 years. So they gave him a total of $2.42 a year.
Yeah, and they're just like, sorry. Sorry about that, dog.
Hey, at least they gave him something.
He was 22 years old at the time. It happened in 1977. His name's Lawrence McKinley. He was convicted of rape and burglary. I can never say that word.
Burglary.
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 Charges and sentenced to 115 years in prison. DNA evidence cleared him in 2008. Okay. And in 2009, they gave him a check for $75. And
Hot damn. Yeah, hallelujah.
The Tennessee Department of Corrections was the ones that said to restart his life.
Those motherfuckers.
But the thing is he said once he got out of jail, he didn't have an ID to cash the check. So he couldn't even cash the check right away.
Money.
And that just sucks.
Yeah, to say the least.
So you're like, ooh, $75. I'm going to get a hooker, you know, that, you know, maybe has a couple, like, you know, just an arm and a leg.
Where
are you
getting a $75 hooker?
Hey, man. Hey, it's out there. Do you ever watch, what's that one? I forget the movie. Never mind. But he's fighting, and he's asking for $1 million from the Board of Claims.
I don't know if you get a mill, but...
Well, they already fucking shut him down.
Yeah, of course.
They already... It was up to the Tennessee Board of Parole. They denied him a 7-0 vote. Like, no.
You're not getting $1 million.
They didn't even get one fucking vote. So, but they're trying to throw it out on him because they're getting a lot of shit for this. And they're like, well, he had 97 infractions while he was in jail.
Well, he was mad about being wrongly imprisoned.
Well, he quoted and he said, yo, I don't deny the infractions. It was prison, man. Like, that's his quote. It was prison, man. Like, what the fuck do you think's going to happen?
Yeah, you got to.
Like, he said people were trying to kill him all the time and everything like that. Like,
yeah, he was a quote unquote rapist in prison. They don't do well.
Mm-mm. And that's the thing. Like, they think he's in there for rape, and rapists do not do well because a lot of these prisoners were raped, and they hate you. Like, you're done. And what do you say here? Oh yeah, he did have a quote here. He's very, like, not bitter about this at all, which I cannot believe.
He's a better man than me.
Yeah. He said, although I spent more than half my life locked up for a crime I did not do, I am not bitter or angry at anyone. Because I found the Lord and married a good wife. This motherfucker can't even get married. Jesus.
I bet you he's nicer to people than you are.
No, I'm a beautiful person.
Uh-huh.
All I ask is...
You were a beautiful plant growing up? Is that, yeah, is that what we're going with?
He says, all I ask is that I be treated right and fair for what has happened to me. I did nothing wrong, and I just want to be treated right. Fair enough.
Well, yeah.
But what really gets me going is I was talking to a friend about this, playing WoW. It's a big surprise.
Yeah, really.
But there is laws actually protecting prosecutors where it's not their fault. And I think there's so many laws. You fucking open a law book and it's just like god awful. Like, it has more terms than the Bible, I think. And I think it's called advocates immunity. I think that's what it's called. But basically, a prosecutor can make a guy look guilty as much as he wants to. He can, you know, set him up, lie, do whatever, and he's just completely immune to it.
Well, that brings up an interesting debate because in a way that's necessary.
Yes, it is. And that's why it's a huge problem right now.
Hmm.
Like, to just,
but it gives you a license to be a scumbag.
Yeah,
too.
Exactly. Well, lawyers, you know. But the thing is like just trying to find information on this, just scrolling through pages of people debating getting rid of this law or not, because it is good, but it also
is necessary. But
yeah.
Yeah.
So it's like, what do you do? And I didn't even know this law. Like, I read this and I was typing to my guild and I was like, oh, this is fucked up, you know? And the one friend was like, you think that's fucked up? And then he started talking about, you know, the advocate's immunity or whatever like that, because he fucking knows everything. He's like over in Europe right now curing AIDS. Like, I'm not joking. Like, he's a genius.
Is your friend watch the show? Give him a little shout out.
No, I don't think he does.
Okay.
But Cuddle Bumpkins.
He's smart. He's smarter than we are. So
I don't know his real name, but his WoW name is Cuddle Bumpkins and he plays a fire mage. Shout out if you watch this. I doubt you do.
Thanks, Cuds.
Yeah. But, I don't know. Like, we're the land of the free, but we can't even get our fucking system right, it seems. Like, that would suck, dude. Like, no wonder lawyers are scumbags. Like, you get laws protecting you to do it.
Yeah, but what do you do if you don't? Like, if something, you been told with all the evidence that was presented to you is right. Mm-hmm. And then you find out later on down the road that it's not, like, you, then you lose your entire livelihood just trying to do your job. I don't know.
There's this got into another debate.
Smarter people than us need to figure this out.
Yeah, I know. And that's the thing. Well, we got into another debate about this when we were talking about this in the guild. But this other girl, she's from Oregon, and she brought up that there was this case where this girl was getting molested by her dad.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what happened is he got sent to jail for it, okay? Her only next legal guardian was her uncle, which was also a child molester on Megan's Law or something.
Oh, good.
But the law state that it has to go to that person. So it was like, so she ended up having to go with her uncle. But the law...
Who's a kid toucher.
Yeah, but it was the state laws. I forget what state she said it in, but that's just the way it works.
Well, that's a dumbass law.
I know. And it's just like, oh my goodness, man. No wonder lawyers get paid enough. If this is what you have to go to school for, dude, you're going to go insane.
Yeah,
like,
really.
Oh, man. Do they just give like prescription meds when you walk in? Like, you're going to need all these.
This is America. You get prescription meds for just... existing.
I know. That's the thing, man. Prescription meds are just like everywhere, dude. We just pop. Like, I don't know. I think we're the only country that really does that. I know other countries do it.
I don't know.
But like, we just like, hey, you got a problem? Just take this pill. Like, your wife's divorced and here's a divorce pill. And they're actually taking...
I cure my problems with minor alcoholism. Yeah,
I know. That's what they did back in the day. I was like, we don't talk about our feelings.
I'm lonely. Let me buy a puppy.
Yeah. And that's another story I read about. They're 3D printing pills now. So you never gonna... In the future, you're never gonna have to go to the pharmacy again. Basically, you get on your computer, you send them, you know, the prescription, and you have a 3D printer by your computer, and it prints out the pills.
Wouldn't that mean that you have tanks full of everything?
I don't know. But this is what I'm thinking. Drug dealers are going to have a field day. And that's the thing. Like, how do you get the drugs through to your computer? But they were saying this is something that's, you know, they're working on. They're 3D printing pills. Hmm. And you're going to be able to do it from your home. But I have no idea how, because... Nanotechnology? I don't know.
I want a 3D printer, but I have no use for it whatsoever.
They're fucking expensive, aren't they? Like $16,000 or something?
Oh, no. They've come way down. You can get one for a few hundred bucks.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You can get one for like $600-$700.
Fuck, I should have asked one for Christmas. Damn it.
But you have to be really good at three-dimensional design. That's the problem.
Well, I went to school for it.
Well, good for you then, because, I mean, I can do two-dimensional shit pretty well.
But, yeah. Yeah, 3D is actually hard at first, but once you get it, it's like...
I just don't think that way. Like, I make a lot of the graphics for this, you know, like the lower third down there and all that sort of shit, and the title cards, I make a lot of those, but I use a service called PicMonkey to help me because I'm fucking not that great of a graphics designer, and I'm lazy. And Casey's already doing all this editing and shit, and even though he's the more artistic of the two of us, he doesn't have time to do it all, so... Yeah. But, I mean, to sit there and actually design things in 3D and figure out where screw posts should go and things like that, that's
it actually beyond sucks. Me. Like, when I went to school for it, I spent 10 hours a day in my room just staring at a fucking computer, and I went insane. I'm not going to lie. I went insane. Like, it would get to the point where I'd be, like, it'd be Friday, and just 10 hours, I'd have to just go somewhere. Like, I started seeing movies again because I just had to see four different walls. Like, it was horrible.
Yeah, but still not talk to people, and that's where movies come in handy.
Yeah, I know. But the thing is like, anything, any video game, like, a lot of people make fun of video games, and anything like Toy Story animated like that, I've come to the conclusion that shit takes so much fucking time, you have no idea. I didn't think there was a bigger time sink than World of Warcraft. There is, and it is fucking time consuming. Holy shit, man.
Well, I'm sure it is.
Oh god. Like, and like, I watch movies these days and stuff like that, and I remember this movie Battleship. It was a horrible movie. But they designed these balls and there's so many moving parts to it, I got anxiety from watching it.
A little late on the rim shot there.
I'm like, whoever made that had no fucking life or is dead probably now. Because just looking at the parts and the animation of it, I was like, they had to have worked on that for 2 years.
Well, what gets me is, like, I'm I guess what you call a maker. Mm-hmm. I like to, like, you know, use those little boards like Arduinos and Raspberry Pis and shit like that and make stuff out of them.
Yeah.
And things like that. And some people are just so talented when they can take and 3D print, like, their own custom Game Boy container case and put all this stuff in and have it designed in their mind so that everything will all screw together properly and have screw posts and places to run wires. Mm-hmm. Everything's mounted properly. However anybody can do that is beyond me. My brain doesn't work that way. Mm-hmm. I can sit there and stick it all together with hot glue and get it all connected up and then say, okay, now what can I fit this in? That I can do. But when it comes to actually designing a custom case, that's just beyond me.
Yeah.
People are fucking smart, man.
I know, man. And that's what I'm saying. Like, I went to college and I've, you know, been around some of the smartest people. Now, I wouldn't say smartest. Well, smart in a way, but they're just, like, the most creative people. Like, this one project we had to do, we had to take something like a coffee mug or something and put a different texture on it.
Mm-hmm.
I did a strawberry hand grenade. It was a grenade with strawberry skin.
Okay, yeah,
this one girl took a Converse sneaker and put Freddy Krueger skin on it. It was the coolest shit. Oh, she had problems.
I would buy those.
I know. She had problems, though. Like, she, like, you sat next to her, and it was just like...
I would love a pair of those.
Dude, it was brilliant. She was the most insane person I've ever met, I think. But they're the good artist. Anyone that's a good artist is insane.
I would especially buy those if every time you took a step, Robert Englund would crack a joke.
Yeah, I know. Bitch. He always said bitch. I watched a couple bitch. Of Nightmare on Elm Streets.
Oh, they're my favorites.
A month ago, yeah. And he always says bitch.
Oh, yeah.
He's always like, bitch.
I still remember there was an episode of Married with Children years ago where Robert Englund played the devil and he was trying to tempt Al Bundy. It was hilarious.
What was he trying to tempt him with? You remember?
I forget.
Or was Al Bundy trying to, like, sell his soul to play good football for Poke High?
I don't know. Probably something like that. I don't know. It was a long time ago. I haven't seen this episode in fucking years. Although they do play that show on TBS every morning.
Oh, yeah. I see it on TBS all the time. I love that show. I didn't. And I always watched it when I was younger. And I
never got any of the jokes. Our parents were awful. They never looked.
I know.
They never checked what we were watching.
I know. That's like we were talking about how Rocco's Modern Life, he was a sex phone operator. We never knew it.
Oh, baby.
Yeah.
Fucking jokes they slipped in Animaniacs.
Yeah.
And Ren and Stimpy is the worst.
Oh, Ren and Stimpy was horrible. And then, yeah, because, like, watching Married with Children now, I just watch it, and I think that whole show was basically just a fuck you against political correctness.
Like, it is, and what gets me, though, is their parent network. It's so that show is so odd, and then, you know, they're owned by a very conservative company, which is so strange.
Yeah, and that's the thing, like, and political correctness wasn't even that bad then. It's worse now, but it's like it was such a big fuck you to, like, that's the way I see it.
I mean, conservatives now rally against political correctness, but back then they didn't. So it was such a strange thing.
And that's the thing. Like, I've not into the parties. I really don't know the difference between parties. But from what I hear a lot of people say,
strange.
The Democrats and Republicans sort of have switched over the years.
Well, they have, but that's beside the point.
Yeah, like, I don't know.
It's just when you think
crooks in my eyes. Like, fuck them.
When you think of a strong conservative, you think of somebody with traditional values and things like that. Yeah. And they'd probably be actually horrified by some of the shit they see in that show.
Yeah.
That's what I find strange about it. And Fox News is completely, completely conservative biased.
Oh, yeah. And that's the thing.
It's like the Huffington Post is completely liberal biased.
Yeah, like, I don't watch the news at all. I fucking hate it. It's the most piece of shit brainwashing stuff out there, but I've always heard, you know, Fox is more conservative, MSNBC is more, you know, and they
liberal,
say
yeah
and they say, oh, we're not though.
Yeah, you are.
So one night I sat down and I watched it straight up. I don't know how they can't hide it. It is so blatantly obvious.
It's confirmation bias.
I know. It just, it made me, like, I was like, and there's, it's funny because people actually think it's not biased. And it's just like,
well, everybody's living in their own echo chambers. Nobody wants to venture outside of it. I'm as guilty as anybody else. I'm not going to lie.
It's just funny, though, because, like, I was like, all right, I'm going to sit down and watch what this fucking fuss is about. I was like, you can't hide this. It's so blunt and obvious.
You'd have liked what I did this morning on Google Plus.
Did you dump under your wife's chest?
We'll discuss that later.
Okay.
What I did on our Google Plus profile, our Openly Hostile Opinions Google Plus profile, some dude that we follow on there posted something like liberal, and he had all the little acronym. Mm. So I posted one that said ham sandwich. It was like hate filled and misogynistic. It just like all this sort of thing. It's like, stop believing all your confirmation bias, people. We can do this for anything.
Yeah. And like, I know it's getting pretty bad. Well, we have a friend. His name's Ron. It's actually his stepdad. And he
that poor bastard. Yeah, he married my mom.
Yeah, he has a Facebook. And he really doesn't use it for that much or whatever like that. But I was surprised. I saw him post something the other day where he was like, "Will everyone please shut the fuck up about the election? It's over. Can we enjoy Christmas now?" Like, and I was surprised. Like, Ron's just fed up, I think.
I know. It's like, I don't agree with Donald Trump in the slightest, but the dude got elected through the Electoral College. We have to just deal with it and move along.
Like, I'm just like, and my phone broke, thank God, because I was like, oh, man. Yeah, I dropped my phone for the 900th time.
The fucker shattered every screen on every phone he's ever had, except for this one right here. And you know why he didn't break this one? Go ahead, tell him.
Because I had a case.
Because he had a case.
It's the only phone I ever bought a case for in the screen, and it's the only phone I've never cracked it.
I've got this one with a nice little case on it.
Oh, man. I was so pissed.
I know they're ugly. I know they suck, but come on. Put a case on your phone, man. No,
I
just
don't think about it. Like, I am the least, like, material. Like,
I throw money at my problems is non-materialistic.
No, like, I'm very, like, what's the best word to use? I don't know. I'd say basic. Like, I forget to eat sometimes. He's a
basic bitch.
Yeah. I just eat because I have to. I hate eating. I think it's annoying. Like, I have to eat.
Ugh. You sound like the guy who created Soylent.
Oh, really?
There's this, like, supplement powder that this guy eats called Soylent, and it's all the vitamins and minerals and shit you need to live.
Yeah.
But it's just, like, the most boring, basic. You just mix it into a shake, drink it, and life.
Annoying's eating.
Eating is annoying.
I'm dyslexic, obviously.
No, you're half drunk.
But see, here's the thing. I've been babying this because look at that. You must be seeing sounds by now. Holy shit, dude.
Nah, I'm fine.
I can't. Like, I'm just like, I get, the thing is why I'm taking so slow. I get really warm when I take a sip.
Oh, yeah, it's very warming.
Because the alcohol just dick punches me like so hard and I can't do
it. Well, the room we use for our studio is very warm to begin with.
Oh, yeah. We turn the heat off because it's so fucking warm in here. It gets so warm. Like, it sort of looks big on camera, but it's not at all.
Tiny little room.
Yeah, like, we actually wanted to put this back here, but we couldn't because it's, like, nailed into the wall. But when I moved in here, I guess this used to be a little girl's room, and there's this really creepy princess sign over here. And we were going to put it back there just to, you know.
It's like, what the fuck's wrong with you?
Yeah, just, like, just for something, but we couldn't get it off the wall. It was, like, nailed there by Satan.
Yo, we need to get our unpaid intern to get in here and fucking do it.
Mm-hmm.
Get in here, bitch! I told you, Robbie! Yeah. Get in here and nail that shit to the wall!
Could you please not yell at me? I'm sorry, I haven't had my muffin yet, Matt. Oh, man.
Okay, I'm looking for my sound, damn it. There
it is. Dude, Matt straight up sucks.
I forgot we had that sound.
Well, it doesn't really have much of a purpose.
Yeah. Did you see the new Star Wars yet?
No, the Rogue One. I don't care.
Yeah,
I'm not at all interested.
I haven't either.
I was only interested before because I think Siths are kind of cool.
Nah.
So, like, I wanted to see what the whole Kylo Ren thing was all about when I saw the other one. And it's just...
Yeah, someone was making fun of it. I was watching Twitch last night and someone was like, can we talk about Star Wars yet? They're like, spoilers, they find the plans of the Death Star. Oh, man. I just found out like a week ago that's what it was about.
Many Bothans, is it? Bothans had to die to get us these plans.
Yeah, I just found out a week ago that's what this movie was about. Like, and it's just like, oh, another movie about the Death Star. That's weird.
I saw a comic the other day, made me laugh, and it had Admiral Akbar on it.
Yeah.
It said, many Bothans died to give us these plans. Like, yeah, that's why I use fucking Bothans. I don't even let them pick up my laundry anymore. I sent them out to get me a cappuccino. All dead. All.
Oh, man. I love that guy. He's awesome. He became a meme, though.
Ooh, ooh. Oh, that last sip.
That's where all the shit settles. Oh, man.
Get my Pepsi Max on.
While Jay's getting drunk here, I guess I'll go on to my next thing here. I think this is just fucking awesome. I'm not the only one that hates young people. And this is proof right here.
Hey, let's just alienate another section of our audience. Why the fuck not?
Fuck yeah, man. I'm a piece of shit. Whatever. I own it. Whatever. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
All right, so Brooklyn Bar raises drinking age to 25 because young people are annoying.
Can you do that legally?
Yeah.
Really?
Because you're private property.
Really? Yep. I don't think you get away with that in PA.
Because
we got the PLCB and they're a pain in the ass.
Yeah, they are. They are a fucking pain in the ass. Like, they came into my friend's bar one time and they're like, I just checked your cooler. You don't have any of that beer and it's advertised in your window. You got to turn that light off. That's illegal. I'm like, okay, Hitler.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. They did
it. The PLCB is ridiculous.
Yeah, they did it to the Angus too. They ran out of Genesee, I think it was. And they're like, you have to turn that light off if you're out of it. They're like, we're getting it tomorrow. And he's like, I don't care. And that's what the PLCB, they're basically like the mafia. They come in, they're like, where's my money? Like, you buy a liquor license to own a bar around here, and they straight up told our friend, you don't really own that, you just rent it from us. Like, they're dicks. They're like the mafia. Like, pay up.
Yeah, you have to pay them certain amounts of money to be open on Sundays, even if you're not if you're not serving alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah, and you have to pay them every year for having your liquor license, and it was like, what, $200 or something a year? Bam,
like
just like
700.
Now, but yeah, they added 700 to it. It was like $300. Now it's like 1,000. Just like that. It doesn't matter if your business doesn't make that much money. Just 1,000, bam, like that. Like, yeah, fuck them. They're like the mafia, like I said. But anyways, we're getting off topic. So
we have topics here?
Yeah, I know. That's the thing. Like, do we? The name of the bar is so great. Phil's Crummy Corner.
That's a place I would hang out at.
Yeah. Oh, they have a problem with underage kids. That's weird, and they call it that. Yeah, they were only serve alcohol to 25 and older on weekends. It's only weekends because shit gets cray cray. Fam, bae, whatever words we're using.
None of that.
The complaints were so intense that the restaurant became the subject of a meeting between the community board and the 76th precinct. So it was getting pretty bad. It was like 113 some calls for the place of just people being fucking assholes. And just a couple quotes, like, there was neighbors there. They're animals. Friday and Saturday night, it's like an animal town. Like, great quote there. And I just care about being able to sleep on Friday and Saturday nights. That's all I care about.
All right, then.
So, yeah. So I'm not the only one that hates young people. And I'm glad they're doing it. I hope everyone does it. I wish I worked in a bar that no fucking little two-year-olds could come in.
No old people either.
Yeah, no old people. Because I'm sick of fucking making sure your goddamn fucking clam chowder is cold or hot enough.
900 degrees.
Yeah.
Let me explain something to all you motherfuckers out there. Cream-based food is not supposed to be served boiling.
Because it separates. Because it fucking separates. Okay?
All
right. Oh, my God. I'm so
Take
mad.
It easy.
Ugh.
Count to 10.
No, this is bullshit. I get so fucking pissed about this stuff because people are so stupid. And another thing, if you do not know what mild means when you order hot wings, don't fucking order them. I had a lady go, does mild mean the spiciness on these wings? I go, yeah, why? She goes, you should really tell people that. I caught me off guard. Who doesn't know that? Who doesn't? We could do a whole episode of the questions I get. Like the one special, we had a meatloaf melt, and they go, "Is that a hot or cold sandwich?" I just want to be like, "It's cold because the ice is melting."
Like, yo, I got a story one time.
Oh man!
Years ago, Casey and I were working together, and I was working in the kitchen at a restaurant, and he was working as a server. And these two ladies come in, and you can tell right away that they're going to be snooty bitches. They're like the kind of chicks that if they took a shower, they drown because their nose is so far up in the air.
And right away, I knew it. I'll take bottled water, not tap water. That was her first thing.
No, they asked if we had well water.
Oh, that's right. That's what it was.
Like, of course we have fucking well water. We're out in the middle of nowhere.
Not even a hello, not even a how you doing. Do you have well water? And I was like, this is going to be insane.
So the lady orders a grilled chicken sandwich. Now, I don't know if any of you folks have ever grilled a piece of chicken, but it takes a couple minutes. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not exactly an instant thing because we're not fucking McDonald's.
Yeah.
And most people do not care for their chicken to be medium rare.
Yeah, exactly.
So I'm back in the kitchen like I always am, just making the food, not thinking anything of it, not realizing why Casey is slowly turning red as time goes by. These people were there a total, I had the ticket in my hand, I think for a total of 3 minutes at the most. just flip the chicken breast, trying to get the other side done so it doesn't, like, get up, walk away, and cluck. And these people stormed the fuck out.
Yeah, it was like...
food was taking too long.
Yeah, they were the only people...
3 minutes.
Yeah, they were the only people in the restaurant. I'd say they were probably waiting a total of, like, 8 minutes, maybe. I forget what the computer says. The computer tells us how long they've been waiting since, you know, you put the ticket in. And I think it said about 8 minutes.
I mean, I had the ticket in my hand 3 minutes.
Yeah, and they walked out because they said the food was taking so long.
Like, so, in the 8 minutes, he had managed to get their drink orders, got them their drinks, got their food order, got it to me.
Mm-hmm.
I started cooking it, and it was 3 minutes later.
Yeah, and I was this close to going out and dumping those salads on their car because they paid for drinks, or they ordered drinks, and they didn't pay for them. They walked out. So if they were going to call the cops on me dumping that shit on their car, I'd be like, you're stealing from us. You stole those drinks from us. But I didn't. I had, like, a clear moment of clarity.
Moment of clarity.
But that pissed me off so bad.
If you're going to be like that, stay home.
I hate entitled people. I can't. When you work in a restaurant, you come to realize how selfish and ungrateful people are.
Well, people have this undue expectation that servers and things need to kiss your ass.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just because they're a tipped employee does not mean that they're beholden to your every whim and desire. Like, I'm sorry, Little Lord Fauntleroy, but you can just take a fucking moment to realize and appreciate what you have in this world and stop being a douche.
Yeah, I know. It's just, for some reason, like you said, like, a while ago, and I think it was on another episode, like, for some reason, people just lose all respect for...
Yeah, they walk through the door, and they just lose their normal... These people could be normal people outside of a restaurant. They are normal. They are completely respectful of others. And they walk through a restaurant, and all of it leaves.
Yep. And they're just like, nibbly.
How's the wine? You know, that brings me to another story. Years ago, I was talking to this. I went somewhere out to eat. We were out on vacation. I went somewhere to eat, and I was talking to the waitress. And, you know, I've been in the business, so I chat up the servers. And we got into the conversation about some of her customers, because somebody was being mean to her. I'm like, wow, that guy's a dick.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, ah, that's nothing. Like, that's normal around here. So somehow she tells me the story about this guy. He comes into her place and asks for a glass of red wine. And so she, of course, goes and brings the glass of red wine. And he takes one sip of it, and he's like, red wine should never be refrigerated. It destroys the bouquet.
I would have been like, what?
And she's like, excuse me? Red wine should never be refrigerated. It destroys the bouquet. And she's like, sir, you realize it's fucking January, right? I do not see why that is relevant. Oh, it's like, because we keep our wine in a fucking wine cellar.
Down
in the basement. We're on the East Coast. Oh. It's fucking cold in January. No, I'm sure she didn't actually say that, but I'm sure she wanted to.
You want to. I just, man. I had another one where, you know, we have two sizes of onion rings, a smaller and a larger one. I asked a couple, what one would you like? They say, what's the difference? I'm not joking. I get this all the
one's
time.
One's big, one's little.
Like, I just, oh my God. It's too much sometimes. I just, like.
Well, we don't want to seem ungrateful for your business. Because we appreciate.
No, I'm joking.
We appreciate you coming in. We want you to have a good time. We do. People who join the service industry, not the ones that last anyway, join the service industry because they genuinely like people and want to, like, work with the people. But when you come and you act like a fucking, you act like a tard. I know that's politically incorrect to say, but if you come in and you should be wearing a helmet and water wings.
I feel like that's what we should be handing out when we get there. I remember one time I had a 10-minute conversation on the texture of our onion rings. Like, because she's like.
They're rings with onion in them.
Like,
outside crunchy, inside soft.
Are they battered? Or are they, what's the other word? Are breaded? Because I don't.
That's a good question. I'll give you that. That's a good question.
I know, but she goes into it. Because the breaded texture I don't like. I like some breaded textures. So imagine working by yourself. You have like six other tables and you have to sit there and explain to this piece of shit what the texture of the onion rings are. I've gotten questions. How many onion rings come in an order? How many clams come in an order?
We don't count them.
I know. Like, Jesus. I haven't been asked
this many,
but I'm waiting. How many fries come in an order? Like, when I get that, I'm just walking out.
37. You get 37.
37 and 3/4.
You might get that one black one. Oh, that one with, man, a little bit of black on the, yeah, end. We won't count that,
dude,
one.
Dude, and like I said, I could go on forever about just the dumb shit that they've said to me. And the thing that sucks is when you're not busy, you can handle it. It's okay. But when you see six other tables that I'm dealing with, I don't have time to fucking talk to you. I just don't. And I'm going to be fucking fair about it. Like we did a special that had the word au gratin in it. And I had to explain to every single table what au gratin is. And you know what? What they say after I explain it? Oh, like the scalloped potatoes.
You know what else those are called? Potatoes au gratin.
Oh, man, I got to drink more. This is stressing me out, dude.
Yo, here's a funny story.
Oh, God.
I often, you guys have probably noticed, I wear a lot of shirts with colleges on them. So today I'm in the grocery store buying beer, and I've given up long ago explaining why I do this to people because I'd have to tell everybody. And then she said, "Oh, Lee College, that's in Tennessee, right?" I'm like, "Yeah, sure." She's like, "Oh, yeah, I was thinking about going there." And like, you know, I'm making small talk. Well, the reality of the situation is I have all these university T-shirts because I asked for them. I read somewhere online that some guy had sent an email to every college in the country and asked if they would send a T-shirt. Well, I did the same thing, except for I didn't act like a moron and sit there and actually send an email to each and every school. I used a mass mailer.
Fucking dick.
So over the course of, instead of like months, like this guy did it, I did it in like 3 days. Well, excuse me, because
I'm burping too. Ugh.
Because I was using Gmail and it only lets you send so many out at a time. But I used the plugin to do a bad mass mailer, and I got a list of every college email and they're out the country, and I got like 40 t-shirts back.
So you did it just to see if it would work?
Kind of, yeah.
I remember you telling me that too. You're like, dude, I just asked every college like in the United States
in the
for
United
a t-shirt.
States, yeah, I did. What? A whole bunch of, I mean, I wasn't mean about it. I just simply said, hey, if you have a t-shirt or anything else you'd like to send, and like, I feel bad for my mail lady, man. She was literally.
Do you still get them at all?
No, it's done. It's done. I got, man, like 2 months where I was just getting tons of mail every day. I would get course books. I would get, I got a bunch of lanyards. I got this bottle opener here is from Seward County Community College, so thank you for that.
Wait, a college is giving beer bottle openers out?
What? Here's the thing. It wasn't just one either. I got a couple of bottle openers from different colleges, and the irony was not lost on me.
That's like a heroin, like a heroin support group giving out needles with AIDS on them. Like, what?
So I'm not advocating you do this because colleges only have so much money, but hey.
Bullshit. Colleges are fucking rich.
Yeah, well, you know what? Here's the deal. Most of the rich colleges didn't send me shit. It's the small ones that did. Now I kind of feel bad about it.
Always picking on the small man.
Yeah, like, you know, a lot of Christian colleges sent me stuff.
Where'd you read this on? You just read it. You were like,
I don't know. I came across it in one of them late night internet sessions.
Oh, yeah.
One of them same ones where you end up on that weird section of YouTube watching people drain abscesses and shit.
Yeah, and pop black. I actually really like it, though, so I'm not gonna
play. I love that shit.
So I do, too. I don't know why. It's, like, satisfying.
Dr. Sandra Lee is a hero.
Yeah, I just don't
get. She's hot, too.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, man, that reminds me. I got to see that new Jennifer Lawrence movie.
Yeah, I haven't seen that yet either.
With Chris Pratt? I'd fuck both of them.
At the same time.
Yeah, I'm going to pull a Pee Wee Herman in that movie theater.
Train him.
I don't even know what the fuck. Actually, to tell you the truth, I don't even know what the fuck a movie's called. It's when they're in space alone or something.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll have to watch.
I just saw Jennifer Lawrence in lingerie, and I'm like, I'm going to see it. What to do? Yep. I would do her.
I looked at her butthole.
Yes.
Fucking Ken Bone.
beautiful human submarines. Oh, man.
If you don't get that joke, watch our back episode.
Yeah, I think it's like episode 3 or something.
I don't know.
If people still watch this.
How long have we been doing this now? We're on episode like 14.
14, I think. Yeah.
14 fucking weeks we've been at this.
Right. It only took us 14 episodes to get a fucking camera that works. Jesus Christ, man. We've been through some shit.
Yeah, you know, our lives are so difficult. We fucking get on the line once a week and talk to people.
No, I actually love it. Like, I look forward to this every day. I don't even know if people really listen to us. Like, I tell you the truth, I really don't.
I don't know.
Like, we get
I look forward to making it anyway.
Yeah,
like,
I know.
Somebody will, someday in the future, people will discover us and be like, we missed this great comedic talent. Yeah.
Like, people are like, we get like, hey, we like your show. We think it's funny and stuff like that. But we're really not sure if anyone watches this or not.
Yeah,
fuck it. We just keep showing up and doing this to tell you the truth because we have no
idea. We are going to keep showing up week after week until you love us.
I know.
Or hate us.
It's going to sort of be like internet rate. But they can't prove it was us. I know, just with this fucking beer.
Woo-hoo! The end of the show gets interesting.
Oh, man, I'm glad I'm done with that, because, dude, I was...
All right, man, I got one more for us before we call it a night.
Go right ahead. Sorry, my head feels like a Tetris game right now. It's just like... All right, go ahead.
So this one's pretty funny. I was going to talk about the California man who fights a DUI charge for driving under the influence of caffeine, but apparently all the national news outlets got a hold of that. So fuck you. So I'm going to talk about something else I find funny. Some Christmas service somewhere accidentally printed the words to Tupac's Hail Mary instead of a Christmas carol. Dude,
I saw that. That's so funny. I saw that last night while I was taking a shit. And I couldn't tell.
It's the Christmas carol service in the Sri Lankan capital of Colombo accidentally printed the lyrics to Tupac Shakur's Hail Mary in his program instead of the 15th century Catholic prayer. Let me go ahead and read the words to you.
Oh, this is great. This is,
I went ahead and looked at the words here, and there is actually a fucking picture. I wish I brought it up ahead of time to show you on the show. But anyway, there's a picture of this thing in the program, and it's got these lyrics on here. It says, Hail Mary, Machiavelli in this, Killuminati, all through your body. The blow's like a 12-gauge shoddy. Feel me. And God said he should send his one begotten son to lead the wild in the ways of man. Follow me, eat my flesh and my flesh. Come with me, Hail Mary, run quick, see, what do we have here? Now do you want to ride or die? La da da, la la la. I ain't a killer, but don't push me. Revenge is like the sweetest joy. Next to getting, I don't know because they blocked it out. Pussy. They get next to pussy. Picture paragraphs unloaded. Wise words being quoted. Peep the weakness in the rap game and skewed it. Bow down. Pray to God, hoping that he's listening. Seeing niggas coming for me. To my diamonds when they glistening. Now pay attention. Rest in peace, Father. I'm a ghost in these killing fields. Hail Mary, catch me if I go. Let's go deep inside the solitary mind of a madman who screams in the dark. Evil lurks, enemies see me flee. Activate my hate, let it break to the flame. Why did I read it like that? Because I don't want a copyright infringement claim.
Dude, the Killuminati with my shoddy, best line ever.
I'm not even getting credit for rhyming the copyright claim with the flame. Motherfucker. Motherfucker!
I'm sorry. I just, that shoddy was those so funny.
Fucking pulled that shit off the top of my head. I don't get nothing.
Oh, man. That is so good.
But I don't know who is fact-checking this. I assume that English is not their first language. Clearly.
I didn't even know Tupac had a song called Hail Mary. Oh, man. That's funny. It'd be funny, like, next week they're like, hey, man, we need some redemption, and they print off like a Hail Mary playbook from the NFL or something. they're like, Charles, you did it again, damn it.
We're sorry. Here's California Love. California Love.
That's a great song. I love that. I love that. You know what I was listening to the other day? I don't know why this brings, because it's not even the same genre. I was listening to Roxette last night.
Oh, that's an oldie.
Yeah, just like a bunch of Roxette. It was like a playlist on YouTube. I was just listening to it, and it was like all Roxette songs. And it was when I was rapping more Christmas presents, and it was awesome.
You should have been listening to rap when you were rapping Christmas presents.
You fucking. We're watching the Today I Found You know what, Jay? That's not punny. What the fuck was that?
Me fucking around trying to do something fun here.
What was that?
I'm trying not to get a copyright claim, so I'm playing this off my phone.
We're still going to get fucking copyright.
All right, everybody. This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. I hope you're all feeling great. I hope you're not sad about George Michael passing away slowly into the night. Thank you to all our patrons at OpenlyHostileOpinion.com. Or, I'm sorry, Patreon.com/OpenlyHostileOpinions.
You really killed that one, Jay.
Watch out.
No, that was a George Michael joke.
We got a new website getting ready to launch called OpenlyHostileOpinions.com. You can go there and watch me build it in real time because I'm a lazy fuck and didn't do it in the last 2 weeks.
Oh, man, you know we're getting copyrighted on this.
Nah, we'll be all right because it's just scratchy shit off my phone. Yeah.
This song is so catchy.
This motherfucker wrote this shit at 17. What'd you do? What'd you do?
Like, I just want to frolic through a forest with a basket of kittens while listening to this.
The song's about fucking cheating on your lover and then, like, feeling bad.
I know. Actually, Seether covered this a while ago.
Oh, really?
It's awesome, actually. Fucking awesome.
Anyway, I hope you all doing good. If you like the show, please be sure to like, subscribe, and share this sexy, sexy show with your friends.
And don't die at 53.
All right, man. We'll see you next week.
Have a good one, everyone. Happy New Year. See you later.
Hope 2017 treats you better.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.